I'm Dr. Dan Manson, professor and department chair for computer information systems in the College of Business at Cal Poly Pomona. My focus for the last 10-12 years has been in information assurance, also known as cybersecurity. I've been involved in developing courses in computer forensics, internet security. Now we have courses in network security, secure web applications. So that's been the area that I've been involved with for the last decade. It's very easy to have your computer compromised on the internet. I receive email on a daily basis that I know has malware. It's amazing how many people care about me on the internet. So I get messages several times a week saying my mailbox quota is full and I better do something about it. Except it's not from Cal Poly Pomona, it's from people that are trying to give me malware. I get offers that seem too good to be true, and the rule of thumb is if something is too good to be true, probably is, about money waiting for me, about how I can be younger and healthier and do all sorts of great things. All I have to do is click. As soon as I click, I know my computer is being compromised and someone is trying to steal my information and probably tap into my bank account. If you're going to drive a car, you have to show that you have some competency and, you know, rules of the road, and your car that you're driving needs to be safe. Well, when we go on the internet, when we go on the information highway today, there's no requirement. You can have a computer that is full of malware, that isn't patched, and you really don't have to know what you're doing to use the internet. But that's how a lot of people get in trouble. So I really believe in security awareness. I believe that secure information security, cybersecurity, is a job for all of us. There are some rules of thumb in cybersecurity. One is that it's only as good as the weakest link. And in many cases, people are the weakest link. It doesn't matter how good the technology is if people don't exercise good behavior. So what you need to do is make sure that your protection on the internet is always up to date. You're always fully patched. That you're using some type of antivirus software, you're using some type of anti-spyware software, that you have a firewall that you're using. But most importantly, don't click on anything that might get you in trouble. Attachments, only open them if you know that they are from someone that you expect to receive the attachment from. Always check if you think something looks fishy. Don't click on links unless you really believe that it's safe to do so. Well, so much of our critical infrastructure uses the internet. We can't do our daily routine of life today without the internet. Our commerce runs on the internet. Our social relationships use the internet. So we all need to care about cybersecurity because so much of our lives involves electronic communication using the World Wide Web. It's very clear what some of our adversaries are doing. Mm-hmm. So over the last 20 or 30 years, China has taken a tremendous amount of intellectual property from this country. That's been the primary goal of China, is to steal our IP. On the other hand, Russia, the hackers in Russia, their primary goal has been to steal financial information. All major countries, to some degree, they get to a point where they are involved with offense as well as defense on the internet. So our country does do some offense and our country does do defense. Defense is a harder skill. It is much harder to defend yourself against many, many people that want to attack you than you launching an attack. The best and brightest in our country need to be at least as good as the best and brightest in other countries. And if we don't develop our talent as much as other countries do, we're going to fall behind in terms of cyber competitions. I think one of the most important things people need to understand is, one, that it is something we all need to be good at. We can't depend on just the people that run computer networks to protect us. We have to have our own behavior. It's like saying that I don't have to worry about having good safety habits when I'm driving down the freeway. I know that the freeway is safe. Well, we know that's not true. You always have to look out for the other guy. Well, all of us have to look out for what's going on in the internet and make safe decisions.